Welcome all. Today we are trying to see something about distributed transactions. So basically we have to understand that a distributed transaction can be flat or nested. We will discuss about it, but basically these transactions will access the objects which are being managed by multiple servers. Okay. As we have seen in distributed system that there will be multiple servers. Okay, so now some transaction that we are going to execute, first of all let me clear that you would have heard about transactions, right? Transaction will be a set of statements, I should say a set of instructions. These instructions to be executed if concurrency is not there, then in sequential order let it be. So basically a transaction is something where different objects are involved, and on those particular objects these particular operations are done, right? Now you have seen these transactions in database management system, where you have a database, and in your database different data objects are there, maybe records of the table or a particular table or something. You want to perform some operation maybe on a part of a table or a whole table, depending on the nature of operation. In that case you have seen what a transaction is. Transaction will involve set of operations to be performed maybe on different part of the database, maybe on different tables, maybe on different other things, right? So now also here we are thinking about the same thing, transaction, but now we are talking about the transaction in distributed environment. Earlier we were having an understanding that we have a centralized server, and whatever a client has to interact, it has to interact with a centralized server, right? So whole database, whatever your data was on this centralized server, so the operations were set of operations, I should say, whatever the transaction I am calling, set of operations were coming and they were executing on this centralized server. So we had to manage this part only. Now we are talking about transaction to be executed on multiple servers in a distributed environment. This means that in the set of operations, certain operation involve the data objects which are on server X. Other operation involve the data object which are at Y, and other data objects involved in some operation are at server Z. So in this distributed transaction you have to understand very simple thing, that now this transaction may involve operations on those data objects which are at different servers, not on a single server. So now these distributed transactions can be flat transaction as well as nested transaction. Okay, so in a flat transaction what happens, a client makes a request to not one server but multiple servers. Okay, so suppose in this example you see transaction T is there, so it is a flat transaction. Why is it a flat transaction? Because it invokes operations on objects in server X, Y and Z. So a flat, I should say, it is flat because it is directly making request to these servers. Okay. So in this case, one can understand that this may be sequential operation. Okay, each transaction here accesses a server, works on it, and then executes the next operation here and executes it. So, in certain case, if it is locked by certain other transaction, in that case, it will have to wait, right? Now, if at all it is nested transaction, what happens? In case of this nested transaction, the suppose the top level transaction is there. It can open sub transactions, and these sub transactions can also open certain sub transactions to execute on further different servers. Okay. And this can go to any level of depth. So here what you can understand in this given image, that this is a transaction T, it creates small sub transactions T1 and T2, it accesses the T1 accesses the object at X, also creates some sub transactions T11, T12. T2 is a sub transaction which uses the data object as at Y, and also creates sub transactions T21 and T22. So here you can understand that this T1 and T2 can execute concurrently, right? At the same time, here also you can see T11, T12, T21 and T22 can execute concurrently. So basically, you have to understand that these sub transactions at one level can execute simultaneously or concurrently. Let us take some example. You can say about this thing. If the client is directly calling using the data object, that is a different case, flat kind of thing. If it creates a sub transaction, the whole transaction is divided into this part. So this is like this. So a transaction creates a sub transaction, it is creating four sub transactions. Suppose it opens a transaction, and between opening and closing the transaction, it opens some sub transactions, okay, to be executing on different servers, on A, on B, on C and on D, okay, data objects. Okay. So now, one thing that we have to understand is how these distributed transactions can be maintained. Okay. Servers that execute requests as part of distributed transaction need to be able to communicate with one another to coordinate their actions when the transaction commits. Okay. So, a client starts a transaction with an open transaction command and closes it with close transaction, right? Some more commands are there, when we will see a two-phase commit kind of thing. We will see some more operations are there, but one thing that we have to understand is that the client will open the transaction and close the transaction, in between it will perform the operations. Okay, so here what we are saying is client will communicate with something, we call it coordinator. This coordinator is not separately somewhere else, it is any one of these, means it is a process on any one of these server. Okay, we are calling these servers as participant in this transaction. This is our client and this is the transaction. So in transaction we have certain operations. You can see here withdrawal 4, deposit 4, withdrawal 3 and deposit 3, right? So the client starts, opens a transaction, and a coordinator is created. And then these participants, will use a join operation. Okay, so while joining, what can they do? They can use two things: the transaction and reference any. Reference of a participant only. Okay, so in this way, these participants can issue join instruction and they can join. Now the thing is, it is not necessary that all of them have already joined with the coordinator before starting the transaction. It may be the case that some participants have not yet joined. So what will happen once the transaction, some operation is issued from the transaction, it involves this part. Suppose it involves the Y server, the data object D, right? So what will happen? It will understand that yes, I have to join to coordinator. So once it receives this, then also it can join with the coordinator. So one thing that we have to understand that in a distributed transaction, till now what available techniques we have and we are studying, we use a coordinator, and coordinator can be any one of these participants. Okay, so then they can access the this coordinator will keep issuing the commands, and these operations can be executed on these servers. Okay, so in the last day, the client can issue close transaction, right? Another thing that we have to understand is abort transaction. Any of the participant in between can ask for abort transaction. Means if there is certain thing that they found that this was some operation that I cannot perform, in that case they can tell other participants or directly to the directly to the coordinator, and through coordinator it will be notified to others. So this participant can notify the coordinator that I cannot complete this part of operation, so the transaction should be aborted. Okay, now your question is why the transaction will be aborted if it has not done its part. One thing that we have to understand is atomic commit. What happens in atomic commit? Basically, this atomicity property says that in a transaction there are multiple operations. So either all of the operations will reflect in the database or none of them. Okay, so it is saying that it requires that when a distributed transactions come to an end, either all of its operations are carried out or none of them. Okay, so this is what we have understood about atomicity in database also, all of the things should be committed or none, right? Similarly here, it is atomicity property in a transaction that all of the operations should be reflected or none of them. It is if we allow to reflect some of the operations and some operations are left, in that case what will happen? The database will become inconsistent, you know? So now we have to understand here is atomic commit protocols in case of distributed system. We have our coordinator and different other participants. So now, from the coordinator, these participants can take some instructions. Very good. Now, how can we assure this atomic commit in this case? One simple way will be that this coordinator will issue, will, when this coordinator understand that now these things can be committed, so it will issue a commit request, right? And this request will come to the participant. Participant will commit whatever the operations have been performed, and it will send an acknowledgement. No problem. So it will send a commit request to all the participants, okay, and all the participants will send the acknowledgement. And once it has received the acknowledgement from all of them, then it will say that okay, it has been committed, right? And what happens if it sends the commit request to the participant and it is not sending the acknowledgement? It will send again the commit request, and it will keep sending the commit request until it gets the acknowledgement. Now, the other thing is, if at all there happens something, there is a network problem or any kind of such thing in which the packets are being dropped and it is not getting the acknowledgement, in that case, what it will do, right? Let it be. This part, what we have seen here, is single phase or one phase atomic commit protocol. Okay, so what I was telling is the problem related to this. What is the problem? If due to some reason this we are not able to communicate with the participant, one of the participant, and our system is, we will keep on sending the commit request, commit request, commit request, and it is not sending the acknowledgement, and we will keep waiting. Okay, so to handle these kind of things, we have two phase atomic commit protocol. Okay, so we will see this two phase atomic commit protocol in next video. Thank you.